Hello everybody, and welcome to this video that will demonstrate to us how you can be able to bind your Royal Q successfully to your Binance wallet. So this is the API binding process. So we're going to show you step by step how to do this. All right, the apps we are going to be using will be the Royal Q app right here and the Binance app, right? So make sure they are already installed on your phone and registered. Okay, you've already registered on them and everything is activated, right? So for the Royal Q, you need to have activated your account first. You must have activated it with the activation fee. You must have paid the 1 year license, which is $120 USDT, $120 worth of USDT. You must have activated that. The second thing is for your Binance, you need to have done intermediate verification. You must have completed your basic verification and your intermediate verification. With these two aspects covered, you can now successfully do your API binding on Royal Q and Binance. Alright, so don't forget Royal Q, you must activate your account with the license fee, and which is $120. And this is a new rule actually. All these are new policies that have been updated. So previously it wasn't like this, but now this is the new way, right? Also, Binance recently updated their policy for everyone using the API to be able to complete their basic and intermediate verification. The intermediate verification will require you to use a government issued ID, being something like your driver's license, your international passport, or any other government issued ID. It must be the card version of it, not a slip. Maybe for some persons using the NIN and all that, so the slip is not accepted, it's just the card. But a voter's card that is really very clear and the images are really very sharp will also suffice. Make sure everything is done properly. So you go through the process and get your intermediate ID verification sorted out. So once you've done that, you can now be able to move forward on this. So quickly, I'll want to start with the Royal Q app for us to be able to use the Royal Q app. Go to the home page, and right here on the home page you can be able to see API binding right here. So when you click on API binding, you will see a page like this where the option for Binance binding and Huobi exchange binding are available. These are the two exchanges that are available on Royal Q to do API binding with. So for this video, we are doing just for Binance, right? So for those who want to use Huobi, remember, if you have been trying to do API binding with Binance and your ID verification for the intermediate verification process is giving you a challenge, you can just register on Huobi Exchange and download the app. But for you to do the API binding, you have to log into your Huobi Exchange on a desktop or a laptop and be able to do the API binding process. Otherwise, you will not be able to do API binding process on your mobile phone for Huobi. But for Binance, you can be able to do that. Now, the Huobi Exchange will be able to give you 90 days to use their API binding without any form of identity verification. All right, after within that period, you can be able to rectify your ID identification documents and be able to upload either for Hubi or Binance, depending on the one you want to use. But after the 90 days, you can always renew that if you've not gotten your ID card for Hubi. So let's continue with the Binance. For us to do the Binance API binding, we click on the Binance button here. So it brings us to a page like this, okay? So here you see the options for us to be able to put in the API key, the secret key, and there's also an IP address we can copy here, all right? So the process now is, first we need to go to Binance and first copy the secret key and paste here, all right? Because the secret key, if the Binance page refreshes, is going to lock. So we're going to copy the secret key first and paste here, and after that we'll do the API key, copy it and paste here. Then from Royal Queue here, we're going to copy this this IP address here and also send to Binance and save it there. And when we save it, then we'll come back here, and the verification code that you're seeing below here, we'll click on the send button to send the code to our email. After getting that code from the email, you paste it in here, then you accept the terms and conditions and you bind. So we'll take that step by step, and you're going to see how we're going to do it. All right, so right now to open the Binance, we click on the Binance icon. So it will take us straight to the Binance. All right, so you need to, if your Binance is still displaying like this, that means your Binance is still on the light mode, all right? So you need to take your Binance to the professional version, right? So the professional version, for you to make use of it, you have to click at the, you see the human icon. There is a human icon at the top left here. So you click on it. When you click on it, it will bring you to this page. So you also need to see if you have done your intermediate verification. This green bar at the top right will be showing you intermediate verified, right? So once you see this intermediate verified, that means you can do the API binding. But for those who are on light mode, you need to change it to the professional mode. This yellow button that you're seeing here, you have to shift it towards the left. So when you shift it towards the left, it's going to change your Binance to the Binance Pro, right? So this is what the Binance Pro version looks like. So the next thing you have to do now is to go to the API section. So for us to do that, we have to click on More. More is right here. So when we click on the More, okay, and this home page here, the More button is around this this buttons that are here, the eight buttons somewhere around the middle. You see the one by the right side, you see More there, just click on it. So when you see it, you scroll down to API management at the bottom here. API management at the bottom, you click on API management. So it's going to bring you to a page like this, where you're going to see your where you can create the API. So I've already done my API, but I'm going to walk you through how to demonstrate everything, okay? So for first timers who have not been able to successfully do this, it will only show you this space at the bottom, at the top here, where it says label API key to proceed. then it will show you this create API. Now, but all the other information below is not going to be showing you that, right? But I have already done mine, so it's already enabled, all right? So what I need you to do now is to type Royal Q here. Just type Royal Q in here. Then you click on create API, right? It's just a label that you just want to tag this one. So you can have different APIs generated for different apps that you want to work with, understand? But this one we're generating is specifically for Royal Q. So it's just to identify it. It doesn't really mean anything. So whether it's in capital letters or small letters, it doesn't matter, right? So when you click on this create API, what you're going to see next is it's going to bring up the option for you to do pass through your security codes, all right? Because they want to be sure that it's actually the owner of this account that is accessing the API section, all right? Because it's a very sensitive section of your Binance wallet. So when you go through that, you see when the next page comes up, it's going to ask you to send a code to your email or to send a code to your SMS, your phone number. Then you get those codes and paste in there. So for those who it may require Google Authenticator, then you can also get a code from your Google Authenticator and pass through. Once you have gone through that successfully, then it should bring you to this page like this, that is going to show your API key, right? So when it's showing your API key like this, what you need to do is you will not copy this API key first. You need to copy the security key first, all right? Copy the security key first. Sorry, secret key. Now to see the secret key, there's this arrow in the middle here at the bottom, all right? So all you need to do is tap on that arrow to show your secret key. So when you tap on it, it's going to show something like this. So you scroll down again, you see the API key is still showing there. Now the secret key will show here under where these dots are showing, right? But it's not showing on mine now because I have already refreshed this page, right? But for you that is just doing it for the first time, this security key will show, and it's similar to your API key. It's just long like this, so it's going to show something like that. So all you need to do is to copy that security key first, because if you leave this page is going to refresh. So you copy it first, and go to your Royal Q app and paste it in the security key section for the binding, in the binding section. All right. So copy, highlight the not this one. Just do something like this. Hold this alphanumeric code for the security key first. Sorry, for the secret key first of all. Copy it, and you now take it to your Royal Q app and paste there. So, but we'll come back and copy the API key. The reason is, like I said, if we leave this page now, and maybe we minimize, you don't have to go back. All you need to do is minimize. If you minimize it like this, and you want to go to your Royal Q app, what it's going to do is that this, by the time you come back, this page may refresh, okay? And once it refreshes, this secret key is going to lock, okay? It's going to lock. So in order for that not to happen, you copy the secret key first, all right? Then later you can come back to copy the API key, because the API key does not lock. Let's quickly do that. Assuming maybe you have copied the secret key, now we'll go to the Royal Q app. Okay, that's the Royal Q. So we'll first of all copy the secret key and paste here. All right. So after that, we have to go back to Binance and get the API key. All right. So we'll go back to Binance. So we'll come back here and copy the API key as well. So copy it carefully, and we'll go back to the Royal Q and paste the API key as well. Alright, so after pasting the API key, and then the IP address that is here, these numbers that are here where you see copy by the side, you click on the copy button. So it's gonna copy those codes successfully, and you go to your Royal Q, and remember you would have clicked at the edit button at the top. And when you click at the edit button at the top, all these buttons will open. So the first thing you do here is to click on enable spot and margin trading. That is the only button you click on. You understand? That's all you click on. You make sure orders are not clicked, withdrawal and orders are not clicked. So it's only the enable reading and enable spot margin trading that will be selected. Then you come to the bottom here. After this section where you see something written in red, below it you see restrict access to trusted IP only. So you select that button, all right? You enable the button there, so that it turns yellow. Then a space will appear underneath for you to paste the IP addresses. So you paste those IP addresses, they'll be showing like this. Beside it, you see a confirm button. And you click on the confirm button, all right? You just paste those IP addresses, something like this. Then you click on the confirm button, all right? So when you click on the confirm button, then you have to go back to the top and click on save. The save button, you have to go back and click on this save button so that you can be able to complete the process. All right, when you click on this save button, it's gonna ask you for your email codes and your email verification code and your SMS verification code, or maybe Google Authenticator. And when you key that in, it's going to save your API binding here. Then you have to go back to Royal Q. You now go back to Royal Q, and you come back to Royal Q. At this point, you now send a verification code. This space where you see the verification code, you click on the send button. So they'll send a code to your email. All right. So when that is sent, you have to go to your email. You have to come to your email, look for your email. All right. You look for the code. All right. So when you get the code, it's going to come as a Royal Q code. You click on it, it's going to open up, you copy it, and you go back to your Royal Q, and you paste that code within that time frame before it elapses. You accept the terms and conditions, all right? Then you click on the bind button. So once you click on the bind button, it will turn to orange, right? So that will complete your process. So we'll go ahead and click on the bind button now. You are good to go. So thank you very much.